Okay, good morning. Once again, this is Santos Capilan Jr. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is the part 4 of my video series tutorial in building management system. Okay, in my previous video, I showed you predefined data point schedule in project specification. Okay, so I said if you are the BMS engineer of a solution provider, then you need to create also, or you need to define your own BMS point schedule, okay? So your basis is the project specification. Now, as I said, you are very lucky if your project, it has a predefined data point schedule, okay? So what you will do, you will create your own BMS point schedule, okay? Now, what I have in my screen is an example of BMS point schedule prepared by a BMS engineer of Honeywell. Okay, now actually this project is there are two BMS engineers. I am the BMS engineer of this project from the MEP company. So we are the MEP company. We have this own project. Then we invited several players in building management system like Honeywell, Trane, Siemens, Delta Controls, Allerton to give their offer or their tender for this project. Okay, so based on these offers from different players, we will select which one is more cost friendly and which one covers everything as per the tender documents. Okay, so the solution provider that won the offer is Honeywell. Okay, this one is selected by our management. Okay, so in this DPS, first you will see the different equipment in the first column. Okay, so under the hotel, actually I said this is a 5-star hotel. So under the hotel, so from the basement level, you have seen one mechanical room there. Okay, so in that mechanical room, based on the drawings, mechanical drawings and electrical drawings, you have seen one mechanical room in the basement area. Okay, then in that mechanical room, there is one air handling unit. Okay, so actually that is AHU-27. So meaning in this project, there are around 27 air handling units. Okay, so this air handling unit is a variable volume. Okay, when you say variable volume, meaning the air being delivered by this air handling unit is variable. Okay, so how this AHU will do that? Of course, they have to put a variable frequency drive so that the volume of air can be adjusted. Okay, so in the first column, you will see there the point description. Okay, so fresh air damper command and the status. Okay, so air handling unit variable volume AHU-27 quantity 1. Okay, then fresh air damper command and status, so analog input 1, damper command and status. Actually this one should be considered as okay, so this is an analog input. Okay, because he's going to show the current opening of fresh air and return air numbers. Okay, that's why it is under the analog inputs. That's correct. Okay, now analog outputs, there are also, it will be also reflected in the analog output. So what is this analog output? Of course, you since this dampers are modulating, so you will give the analog output signal for the damper actuator. So you can give 10 volts so that it will open 100%, or you can give 0 volts so that this damper will close or will go in the closed position. Okay, so let us discuss this fresh air damper command and its status. So 1 point for analog input. Okay, so this is the current opening of that fresh air damper. Then 1 point for analog output. This is the command for that damper actuator. Okay. Now, as you can see here, you will see the part number. Now, what is this part number? Okay. So here, this engineer is giving me the part number of the damper actuator. Okay. So the part number is N110. Okay. Then the brand is Honeywell. Okay. Likewise, in the return air damper command status, the same point, then the same field device. Okay. So this part number or this part number or this column are the field devices. Okay. As I said, when you are defining your DPS, so you will be also defining your field devices. Okay. So let's go to the next BMS points. Run status, airflow proving differential pressure switch. Okay. So one point in the digital inputs. Okay. So status. So meaning you will give a run status. So this is a digital. Okay. So what is going to provide is DPS 400. So actually, this is the differential pressure switch that will tell your that will tell the operator that the air handling unit is already running. Okay. So SA hand up auto position. Okay. So again, SA hand up auto position. Okay. This is a bolt free contact. Others. So meaning when you see there others, meaning this solution provider company will not provide this field device. So this one is will be provided by the MEP company. Actually, these points like run status, supply air hand up auto position. Okay, these are coming from the motor control. Okay, or from the MCC. Okay, so this one, this data point schedule will give you an idea how are you going to estimate the cost or the cost of the project, okay? By specifying all the points and specifying all the field devices, you have an idea how are you going to do the costing of the project, okay? So this is an example of a BMS point schedule, okay? Now let me show you the for the chillers, okay? Now, for the chillers, okay, I have here chillers. Now, in my previous video, I've shown you the predefined DPS, and the first item there is the chiller plant manager, okay? Now, actually, the chiller plant manager here, as you can see here, it says chillers, then chilled water pump, four numbers, drawing 8608. Now, as you can see, there are no points allocation. Okay, then it says here via software with CPM. Actually, what he means is via software integration. So meaning they will not be the one to do the chiller plant manager. So another company like Train will be the one to do the chiller plant manager. Then this chiller plant manager will be integrated to the building management system. So all the points from the chiller plant manager will be integrated to the chiller management through software integration. When you say software integration, this is not physical wires, okay? So there will be no physical wires connected between the BMS and the chiller plant manager. So the points or the monitoring points will be transferred from CPM to Honeywell system through software integration. So all you need to do is run one communication cable between CPM and BMS system so that they can share the information. Okay, but as you know, this is an IP base, so it's very easy to do the software integration if it is a IP based system. Okay, so in this tutorial, I have shown you the data point schedule prepared by the solution provider BMS engineer. As you can see, this Excel file, actually this is from an Excel file. So I think this is around 50 pages, okay? So meaning the project is big because you have 50 pages of data points schedule, okay? Now, again, in this video tutorial, in this series, I have shown you the DPS defined by a BMS engineer of a solution provider, and it will be checked by a BMS engineer of MEP company, okay? Now, again, I think this is enough for this short video clip. So I do hope you have now an idea how data point schedule is being defined and finalized in a BMS project. Thank you very much for watching this video. And once again, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe and click the notification bell. And like I said, God bless us all and be safe.